Hello, everyone. Let's look at load testing using Python. We can define our tests in regular Python code. We use this Locust framework, which is open source. This is the GitHub page. 25,000 stars, getting quite popular. And it's an open source performance load testing tool for HTTP and other protocols. It's developer friendly. Approach lets you define tests in regular Python code. So what I'm going to do in this video is just do a quick demo of this. I'm sure there'll be many better tutorials than this out there, but I just wanted to kind of give a bit of awareness to this project because it does seem to be quite excellent. So I've started using UV to create my projects, and this has got me so like source look. I would actually, I don't know about you, but I would actually prefer if it just created me a source directory, and then I could put my file in there, but I have to go down two levels, but that's just UV. Right, let's construct on Locust. So I'm just going to run it and show you it running. So Locust, and it's running. And when I'll just make that slightly smaller. You can see it's running on port 8089. And I've actually got my own little homemade web server running in the background, which we'll look at in a minute. But HTTP. So the port I'm putting in here is 8080. It's not what I just showed you here. This is the port that the Locust GUI is running on. This is the port that my server is running on. So if we start this, and it really hammers the server and gradually increases the requests. And if you get it wrong, you'll see failures there in the right hand side. You see failures 0% in a moment. And all it's doing is going to the hello endpoint. So unless you get the endpoint URL wrong, if you got the endpoint URL wrong, you would end up with loads of failures. So 3 milliseconds average for charts, you get a graph. It's fairly stable. Failure zero, exception zero, current ratio. Download data, you can get a CSV of your tests. I'm running this on a Pop OS Dell Latitude 5490, I believe it is, with it's about 5 years old with 8 gig of RAM. So yeah. You can also do distributed tests as well across several machines, you know, over multiple CPU cores or machines. Right, so I'll just quickly show you this server that is running, and this is probably where a lot of people will disappear. This is just a little mini HTTP server that I made in Rust. So but I need to show you this because this is where I've put in the port. So whatever you put in here, when you write code, your server, your HTTP server, and then you just need to send back a HTTP 1.1 message. So yeah, that's, I'm sure half the viewers have now switched off because they don't like Rust, but there we go. So that's a quick whistle stop tour of Locust. You can also use command line. If I remember correctly, I did it earlier this morning and I've forgotten how to do it, but I think the instructions are down here somewhere. Wrap calls, visualizing Grafana, documentation. Let's go over to the, there we go. This is the Python friendly bit that we want. And that's where they've started using UV as well, which is nice. Command line web U, running without the web UI is what we want. And then you see you get all the output in the CLI. So let's copy that. Now I'm about to stop the GUI version. Clear. And just need to that won't work. What did I call my file? Locust file. So I'm just backspacing on the directories there because I'm already in the correct directory. So locust dash f locust file dot py headless dash u 100 r5. What do they mean? Not sure. Let's just run it anyway. The documentation's. Oh, we got an error. No, it's working. And it's doing square root of. I think that's because I did I put in the correct endpoint? Running. Right. Let's. You must specify the base host. Okay. What is the base host? There we go. Let's try this instead. I think this is probably what I had working earlier. I can RTFM in due course. So local host 8080. That's better. Ramping up. So I've got a transparent background on, haven't I? But hopefully you can still see what's going on here. We're doing the get requests. You can see the endpoint there. Hello. The number of requests is up to 4,000, 5,000. Failures. Oh, we have some failures. 332 per second. Oh, I think we've got all failures. Connection refused. Ah, no. That's because I didn't have the server running. So, go run the server. Now we'll run the code again. So it's locust dash dash headless dash dash users 10 dash spawn dash rate 1. This is purely a demo, not a tutorial. So yeah, you consult the documentation. So now we can see the failures is down to zero. So that's what we wanted. So all good. If you want to see what command I just issued there, so I did that. Fact, let me clear the screen. There we go. So it's at the top. Locust dash dash headless dash dash users 10 spawn rate. Now that's the URL of your server. So that actually could be remote, and that's what it was to start with. It was something.com. So yeah. Head on over to Locust, your first test. You can test other protocols, XML, gRPC, REST. You can automate distributed runs over SSH. Why? So there we go. Quick roundup of using Locust, just a project which I thought was worthy of a video. Hopefully you like these videos. If anybody would like a subsequent video on, I'm thinking about doing another video about Python jobs in the UK. I think these are kind of quite interesting, or they will be in the future. They'll be interesting snapshots of the work. the employment opportunities available with Python skills. I'm noticing a massive trend towards AI, obviously. A lot of the Python AI data or AI engineer jobs or AI developer jobs, a lot of them are now requiring master's degrees in computer science. So the salaries are big, but it's becoming more like a small pool of postgraduate or master's degree people rather than, mid-level or low level, so junior level, sorry. All right, there we go. I wasn't really concentrating when I was just talking, then apologies for that. But there we go. That's the roundup of Locust. Locust.cloud, and it's on docs.locust.io. And you can use Python to do some pretty cool tests. Automating evaluate load testing with Locust. I kept the video there as well. Thanks for watching. I'll be back soon.